I need to prove that farming in the city is a viable business. So it's not just proving to my wife that it is, I have to prove to the city that it can be done. So that has been the journey, is proving it. I put a seed down and I get a whole slew of tomatoes from one seed. I mean, nature itself is optimistic. You know, one seed, just give it good soil. So my theory in life is the same thing. I just need good soil and I'm good to go. Food is supposed to be available for all. That I believe that strongly. The challenge we have, and it's a bigger conversation, you know, food is political. And there are some places that you can go to and really have a tough time from their point of view to actually go find food. For example, the place where I live, anyone from that community housing that I support, they have to take a bus to go to the grocery store and wait for another bus to come back. Well, if you are a senior citizen and you really have to push that cart all the way up the hill and cart all the way back, it's just it's troubling. We don't have enough growers and we don't have enough open growing spaces yet. So before I make the case, I would have proven that neighbors can feed neighbors, and forget the political alliances. If I can feed my neighbor is healthy because of me, I don't need to be praised, but I'm happy that he's healthy or she is healthy or they're healthy. That's the way it should be. How the city functions. We grow our own food. We have 1,000+ countless numbers of local farmers. Go to any grocery store, you find potatoes from Scarborough, hot peppers from Brampton, or you know what I mean? Like just locally grown food that we are all celebrating. Rooftops, backyards, front yards. You fly around the city or fly into the city. That's all you see, is just open farms that function for the city and fueling the city. Identify your community, right? Identifying your community requires you to know who your neighbors are, you know, by name, not just by passing by, hi. No, you know them. You spend time with them. We talked about food being a neutral ground, same idea. So I tell them to stop with that, build that community, because that's what fuels, for me today, for real, that's what fuels this and the 6 properties that we have. People who believe in our narrative and want to support the narrative, support us to do what we're doing. Toronto becomes synonymous with growing their local food and sustaining themselves through whatever situation that hits them. They have food. In fact, it is the mecca of locally grown food. I'll be a very happy man. I could die tomorrow, I'd be good.